for Joel's speech. And our second evaluator will be Dr. Jim Anderson.
Joel, was that a good speech, guys?
Yes.
Why was it a good speech? Because he started it, went to the middle, made it to the end, sat down, did burst into flames. It seemed like a good speech, right? So it's an interesting question. Now, Joel is an experienced and accomplished speaker. So my evaluation today will be designed to move Joel to the next level. So Joel did a number of things very well. He started with a question. One of the things I really liked about your speech, Joel, is you stated your goal early on. You told us why you were giving us the speech. I mean, you used a bunch of funky words and stuff like that, so we had to sort of like wrap our heads around that. But you told us exactly why you were giving the speech. And then the rest of the speech, as we listened to you, we were able to go back to the goal and go, okay, great, so he's filling in the gap. And that was fantastic. You used humor in your speech. Your topic is not really the humorous topic in the world, so the humor actually helped us sort of digest sort of the technical content of the speech and stuff like that. No problems with that. Speaking for a snake oil salesman, Inc. You said we didn't want to be like a snake oil salesman. You didn't really explain why. I don't think there's anything. There is a need for snake oil. Okay, so let's agree on that. And to really, you know, belittle anyone who's chosen that as their occupation seems like it's a little self-serving. So Joel, I was watching your speech, and I said, listen, what can I tell Joel that he's doing well? Good news, I came up with something. I don't think you actually gave us a speech. I think you had a conversation. When Joel gives a speech, I look forward to it, because I'm gonna have a chat with a friend. I mean, I like listening to him, but I like listening to Joel in the hall. When he's standing up here, there's really no difference between when he's talking to me in the hall and when he's talking to me now. Your speech came across as a conversation. There was a lot of back and forth. Not some, but a lot. That's what I see in a conversation. A speech is you telling me something. You can work some back and forth into it, but not much, because that turns into a conversation. There's also a tone, I think, that goes with the speech. You're actually telling me something I don't know. You didn't have that news. We were having a chat. You had some interesting information. You're so passing along. Thank you very much. Appreciate you sharing. You had great gestures, but your hands were never still. And you were like faking some of those gestures. Like, they weren't really necessary gestures, okay? So you're sort of flapping up here. Jurassic Park. No, not that at all, but you get the gist. There's a crispness, and it's not really the best way to say it, crispness missing from your speech. Everything's rounded. I like listening to Joel. Joel's a nice guy. There's no hard edges in your speech. You didn't tell anything that shocked me or made me upset or did anything like that, but you never do. So Joel, to wrap this up, good speech from a technical point, no question about that whatsoever, but I think you committed the greatest sin that any of us can ever commit when we give a speech. I will not remember your speech. I will leave here. Once I walk through that door, your speech will be gone. Great speech, but I won't be able to remember it. So the next time you give a speech, I would ask that you think to yourself, what can I do to make this speech memorable?
Thank you, Dr. Jim. Table topics today.